volto muito bom, bom mesmo, outro não já cheguei nem com uma. Suku bulan yang dulu na sa ande dio. Bukara mai iya nya cehenna. Iya nya cehenna, awa nya cehenna. Awo kus sa dio. Ande ace kram yang ande cehenna. Iya nya cehenna de. Dai. Gumajen dia ba ande sa ande sa gumajen dia ba. Ande sa ande ambozu na kuruma na den. Ai ma kon dia ba nande bare ba.
I'm in northeast Nigeria, where there is a massive issue of internally displaced people. Nearly half of them are kids. IRC's comprehensive approach that delivers social and emotional support as well as academic learning and play, as you can see behind me, is something that's giving these kids a lifeline. It's not a luxury to have education in the midst of an emergency, it's an absolute lifeline.
When we started the class, initially you not see them smiling, but as gradually as you go, you see them smiling. There's transformation from these girls. They will sit with their parents and gist and laugh. In fact, some of the girls here do sit their parents down and teach them what they have learned here.
Zo tana gaya min abin da zai fahimtar min da zuciyana kuma tazo mu yi wasa wasa mu yi dariya dariya in na je gida na akwai in na je gida hankali na akwance ina tuna abin da ta gaya min kuma an bata min rai in na tuna abin da ta gaya min sai in ji dadi.
Would you like to have, do you need more water?
Wai kuna so ruwa nan ko ya ishe ku wani kuna da shi a nan kuna so wani ruwa kuma kuna so ruwa they need more water.
So this borehole will give more water for everyone in the camp.
So wannan borehole wanda yana yi nan zai ba ku ruwa da yawa nan.
Initially, the IRC have identified this community where people were living, and that the daily water supply was less than 15 liters per person per day, and the IRC have put in place this structure which has a capacity of 25,000 liters and is a solar powered borehole with a backup generator to be able to bring water supply to people's life who have been affected by conflict in the northeast.
To the side of me are the scorched earth remnants, the legacy of Boko Haram's attempt to drive people out of their villages and to burn the villages down. I'm heading to Monguno, whose population has more or less doubled over the last 2 years. It's hosting internally displaced people from neighboring local government areas. We are now able to deliver health and nutrition services there.
Here we deal with children that have severe acute malnutrition with muak tape. Muak tape simply means mid upper arm circumference tape, which we use on the left upper arm of a child and screen. If the child has severe acute malnutrition, we admit them and give them ready-to-use therapeutic food. Those that have medical complications, we refer them to stabilization center for better management.
Behind me is IRC's Severe Malnutrition Stabilization Center. There are 40 beds with 40 women and a lot of children. Thank goodness for the combined health, nutrition and psychosocial work that's going on behind us, because this is an effort not just to treat the symptoms of malnutrition, it's also part of a drive to make sure that we follow up with these families and try to ensure that these children aren't back here in 6, 10 or 15 weeks' time. What's the message that comes through when you ask the parents what they want when they get out of here? Above all, it's education for the kids, and so this is a clear pointer to the priorities that need to drive both the humanitarian sector and the government.
Shine zina zama haka ba sa karuwa kuma ba sa koyi da abu da dama ba dadi ni ma ba iyawa ne iya sosai wanda zan iya koya musu a gida ya fi na yan malamai ba so su zama abu mai kyau kamar su ma su yi kamar yanda yan uwansu suna yi su yi makaranta su gama su samu aiki su samu su biya bukatar su da shi.
It's an incredibly moving experience to see the extraordinary care and attention that's going on to every individual case. So much of the humanitarian crisis dehumanizes people through numbers. Here's the human face, and here it's being treated with dignity and with security.